Then in turn, because of our selfish and wicked ways, because truly we only enter into a sexual relationship not because we love a woman, but because we lust after her, it brings forth a child, as God said it would. Yes, sir. I forgive you. What's your name? Michael? Yeah, Michael, I don't say anything that I say because I hate people. I love people, and I know it's truth that makes people free. And so, I don't remember the specific question I asked you. I think it was... You know, like, even though there is, like, certain things that maybe you and I may never experience, we could actually still say that it's wrong. It doesn't matter who we are, black, white, male, female. You know, if you were torturing little puppies in your backyard, even though I'm not a puppy, I could still say that's wrong, you know?
Right.
So... Judging according to scripture is to be done with righteous judgment, not hypocritical judgment. In other words, if I was out here and I was getting women pregnant and I was taking them to an abortion clinic, and then I'm standing out in front of an abortion clinic saying, you're wrong, and then I'm actually doing it myself, that is hypocrisy. But if God has cleansed me, he's forgiven me, he saved me from my sins, as I know he has, I'm standing out here not as though I'm better than anybody else, but more of like, please don't make this mistake. I was just talking to a young man that got off the school bus. His name is James, right after you. And he's 15, 16 years old. I said, because in America, because of the quote unquote sexual revolution, because of the rebellion against God's law, that we don't care about keeping the marriage bed pure. And I know because I was one of them. I didn't care, I only cared about myself. Because we don't care about that. We actually, what naturally happens when you sleep with a woman, it's not like rocket science. Like, what do you think is going to happen? But sadly, because of sin, we don't think about it. And then, oh no, shocker, a baby was conceived. And you know that half of the pregnancies that happen in America, they say are unplanned. And they're not ready for. What do you think happens to almost 100% of those unplanned pregnancies? They abort them. But, I'm sorry? We're together for the same cause. I wouldn't say we're from the same church or anything like that. But, well, I wouldn't say it's my group. We just know each other. I didn't even know they were going to be here, honestly. Yeah. So it's just common cause of, like, I mean, sadly, we don't even think about this, but like I was telling James, if you one day get a girl pregnant, and then you decide, oh no, I cannot take care of this kid. I'm 16 years old. If you say the only option I have is to have an abortion, then that is what's going to happen to your child. That's what's crazy about this is that is what's happening in there. And if you or I were walking down the street and we saw a mother in collusion with a man chopping her child up, what would we do? Get on the phone, right? Elise? I'm thankful to the Lord. I don't believe that you yourself felt that way, but I think the Lord...
I was just going through something that second, and I took it out on you, so I said on my way back, I apologize.
May I give you something to check out? This doesn't have to do specifically with abortion. It has to do with just your relationship with God. And it's like fill in the blank.
Yeah, I see it on the back right there.
Yeah. So it's fill in the blank, and then and it's only two pages. And then on here, like, are all the answers. And I put them in bold just to make it easier.
You ain't got no card? Like I told you, you ain't no card.
Comp- compiled from A.W. Pink's The Way of Salvation by Luke. That's my name. There's my number right there. I'm an evangelist of McGregor Road Baptist Church. It's in Acton. It's considered Indianapolis, but like a little suburb of Indianapolis.
Okay. So, well, man, nice talking to you, man.
You too, yeah, praise God. That'd be great.
Right. Yeah.
You too. Lisa, do you go to church anywhere?
I don't. I actually just moved here.
Okay.
This is a friend of mine here.
Hi, my name's Luke. Huh. I give you this. It's just a study on salvation, on true salvation. Would you say you've been saved before?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of folks have a misinterpretation, basically, what that actually means. You know, a lot of folks would say that just means I've been saved from hell. And I can live however I want to.
There's so much more than that.
Yeah. And that explains basically how when Christ died for us, it's so great a salvation as Hebrews says. So sadly, the reason I think that this is happening, this is like almost a blood spraying out of the ground, you know. But there's like an artery somewhere else where there's a hole cut. And we're trying to like stop it right here, but in reality it's because of sin against God, where we don't honor God in the marriage bed, that needs to be stopped first. And only the Lord Jesus can do that. Yeah. Praise God. We're praying for you.
Thank
you, Lisa. Just give me a call whenever you want to, okay? Thank you very much.
She just come talk to you. Yeah, it looks like there's an emergency. But she just pulled up.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Bye. Well, I hope she calls.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm excited now.
Mm-hmm. It's like when you, I mean, the worst thing ever when you're out is when you preach to folks and they reject it.
Oh,
and you know that could possibly mean that they spend an eternity in hell.
You're right.
But it's amazing that sometimes when you're out and you get that over and over and over again, then you get that one person.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, so, that guy actually that came up and came back and talked to me, he like very severely cursed me out when he was walking by.
The other way.
Yeah, and he came back and he said, I just want to apologize to you. I was wrong.
Wow.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
And I was able to explain to him, you know, that's what's happening here.
Yeah.
You know, he first said, I don't think it's all right to judge anybody, and I was like, you know, you don't have to.
Can I judge myself? Because I'm a sinner.
Well, I explained the analogy I used. I said, you know, James or Michael, we can judge righteous judgment. You know, like it. You know, we can notice that something's wrong and tell somebody it's wrong. We don't have to actually be that type of person. Like, if you're torturing little puppies in your backyard,
we're gonna say that's wrong.
I don't have to be a puppy to say that's wrong.
Right.
You know, and he said, yeah, I see what you're saying. But praise God.